In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. You hear the long story of today of the born blind. I would like to take just one verse to explore with all of you when our Lord Jesus Christ said, I must work the work of him who sent me. I must work the work of him who sent me. While it is day, the night is coming when no one can work. First of all, our Lord Jesus Christ is telling us that he was sent by the Heavenly Father. I must work the work of him who sent me. Another place in John chapter 20, 21, he informed his apostles when he said, as my Heavenly Father has sent me, I am sending you. And I personally believe that every one of us came to this life, came to this earth, because he was sent by God. Meaning God created us for a reason. God does not do purposeless work. God does not do random work. We are here for a purpose. Our Lord created us and he sent us here to do something. So I would like you to examine your heart and your life and maybe listen to the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is telling you, say, my Father has sent me, I am sending you. To believe in yourself that you are sent by God to the earth to fulfill a purpose. And according to the teaching of our Lord today, the real purpose of our existence is to work the work of God. As if God created us to be his hand, to be his eye, to be his extension on earth, to work his work, according to his teaching today. He said, I must work the work of God. So if you believe about yourself that you are created by God's hand and he sent you here to work his work, not for anything else. And our Lord Jesus Christ is commanding us today, I must work the work of him who sent me, and we can say the same with him. Everyone can tell himself, I must work the work of him who sent me, because I am sent here for a reason. And the main reason you are here is to work the work of God. As long as I am in the world, our Lord says, I am the light of the world. And he also commanded us and said, you are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. Yes, he is the real light of the world, but he also gave us the gift to be the light of the world, to be the salt of the earth. Not because of ourselves, but because he promised us that he will live in us, he will dwell in us. We are the dwelling of the Holy Spirit. We are the dwelling of our Lord Jesus Christ. He lives in us. As long as we are cleansing our human nature to be as pure as possible, as transparent as possible, we will reflect his light to the world, and in this way will be the light of the world. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. I don't want you to be overwhelmed when you hear me saying we are here to do the work of God. Because the work of God might be something very simple. I will give you a very simple example. always I invite the young boys, come, come fast. Always I invite the young boys like this age to be dressed as a deacon and to serve with me. I invite them. When I go to a young boy and I invite him to be a deacon with me, he always says, but I don't know how. I don't know how to serve. And I reply to him, how about to come next to me in the altar and carry a candle for me? He said, yes, I can do that. Carrying a candle is easy. Right? Correct? Easy. Surface. Carrying a candle. Do you like to carry a candle? Yes. So how about for every one of us to claim the job of a candle holder in life? Can you be a candle holder? Is that too much? I remember back there in Egypt, like maybe 20 years or more, we used often to be out of power. And sometimes if we have some guests at home, and we are out of power, stairs are totally dark. And the guest does not know the way. So that one of the household will carry a flashlight, correct? And will go before him to lighten the way. Do you think carrying a flashlight or a candle is a tough job? Is it? I ask a young boy to come help me and be the candle carrier. Hold a candle. In reality, it sounds very simple. But as much as Christ our Lord will shine in our life, we will be naturally a candle holder. We will lighten the way to the people. And because of that, we can do the work of God in a very simple way. Our Lord Jesus Christ assured us, if you give a cup of water is not forgotten before me. If you do any simple act, it can be the work of God. I always love to mention the example of Simon the shoesmaker, Qaddis Sam'an al-Kharraz. Was a very simple man. He does not have special talents, but he had a heart filled with love to God and to people. And he cried out to God, I would love to do your work. I must do the work. I must work the work of him who sent me. I am here to do your work. And God guided him, go to the well, fill water in a container, and deliver it to the disabled people and the elderly. This is his job. Is it too much of a job? Is it hard? Or is it simple? Huh? Simple. Correct? However, God considered 100% what our father, Simon the shoemaker, was doing is the work of God. My point is, being a candle holder, being a water carrier to the people, give a cup of water, do any simple act, as long as it's coming out of a real heart, who is genuinely wishing to do the work of God, it is the work of God. The door is open for all of us to do the work of God. And our life is all about, we are here for one purpose, according to what we learned from our role today. I must work the work of him who sent me. Every one of us can say the same. I am here to work the work of him who sent me. And find for yourself a job to do with God, even if it is something very simple. Very simple. Do. That will create a purpose for your life. And that will create a meaning for your life. And that will make you a co-worker with God. even if your work, again, is something very, very simple. Remember that when our Lord Jesus Christ was in the temple, and the widow get into, and she donated 2 mites, like fraction of the penny. 2 mites means a fraction of the penny. But she donated wholeheartedly. She donated with love. She donated with enthusiasm. What our religious Christ said to the apostles, to the disciples, he said, "Assuredly, I tell you that this widow, this woman, gave more than all." A fraction in a penny, a fraction of a penny from the widow became in God's eye greater than the great work people are doing, because it was something coming out of a real heart with a real love from a simple lady. God is accepting our work regardless to how simple the work we are doing for him. But we have to be very sure that we are here because he sent us, and he sent us because he wanted us to work his work in any way you can. And he commanded us, number two, is to do this work while it is day, because night is coming. One of the most foolish, mistake sometimes we do is we think that our earthly life is permanent, and we keep planning and planning for decades to come. But in reality, today our Lord Jesus Christ is commanding us work while it is day, because the night is coming. What does he mean by the day and the night? The very simple basic meaning is day is our life and night is our death. Now you are in the light. You can work the work of God. After a while, night is coming when no one can do work. So death is a night. It's coming. And now you have in your hand is a day. So do the work of God now. Now. Start when to do the work of God. Not after the liturgy is over. Start now. Start now. If you remember in Luke 15, when our Lord Jesus Christ was teaching us about the prodigal son, when he came back to himself, he said, "I will arise now and go to my father." If you'd like to do the work of God, do it now. If you'd like to repent, repent now. Now, not after the sermon. Now. Bow your head before the Lord. Raise up your heart and repent now and receive forgiveness now. This is the work of God. Now, raise up your heart and raise a prayer for whoever in need, a sick, a weak, a stranger, somebody in trouble, somebody in suffering. Raise your heart up now and start doing the work of God, because now is the day time. Can you guarantee, or can I guarantee for you or you for me, that when you get out of the church, you will stay alive? Can any of us guarantee that? So night is coming. When is the day? When is the day? It's now. Correct? So take the chance. Take advantage of the time. And start from now, do the work of God. Whatever the work you can do, even if it is very, very simple work you do with God. While it is day, you can do. Night is coming. Also, the night might mean the time when I cannot do. I am still living, but I became disabled. I lost my power. I lost my energy. I aged. And at that time, it became night for me. Remember, Ecclesiastes chapter 12 is an awesome chapter. When Solomon the prophet is talking through the Holy Spirit, telling us, remember your creator. In the days of your youth, أذكر خالقك في أيام شبابك. مش شبابك يعني وانت صغير. The day of youth is mean when you are young, when you are able. In your 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. As long as you are able, they are the days of your youth. What to do? Remember your creator in the day of your youth, before the days of troubles come. And he proceeded in a lovely chapter. I wish you would read it. Explaining how when we will get old or sick, we will start to lose it. Right now we have it. Mostly, or we have part of it. If we are too old. Right? But a time will come when we'll lose it. I remember. Like some years ago, a priest in our church, got cancer, became cancer patient. And his doctor, after he became like a terminal patient, was almost dying, his doctor told him, listen, the tumor went to your brain, maybe expect in some weeks you will lose sight. And after a while, you might lose hearing. So that was like maybe 40 years ago or something like that. We didn't have enough digital recording and the internet and the YouTube. And he used it to love his Bible. So he asked his wife, hurry up, please, buy for me some cassette tapes. Because I wanted to record the pieces I love from the Bible, read and record, so that once I lost my sight, I will play it and listen to what I like it from the Bible. So now you have it. Now you are in the day, according to the wise teaching of our Lord is telling us, now you are in the day. Work the work of God now because the night is coming. Remember your Lord, your Creator, in the days of your youth, before the days of troubles come. And Solomon the prophet proceeded in explaining what is meant by the days of trouble. When after a while you will age, your sight will be weak, correct? Your ears will be weak. Wouldn't be able to listen well. Your legs wouldn't be able to carry you after a while. Your arms will be weak. Maybe you wouldn't be able to fast, or wouldn't be able to understand even the word of God, or you wouldn't be able to do the good you wish to do, but maybe you cannot do. So now, work the work of God while it is day, because the night is coming when nobody can do the work of God. My last point is, what is the best way to do the work of God? If we looked at God, our Creator, in relation to us, you will see that God is practicing two main things in our life. He practices tons of things, but I focus on main two. Number one, he practiced salvation. God loves to save people. God loves to forgive people. God loves to attract people to his kingdom. God loves to create children for him. He goes around to attract people. Come, come, be my children. Come, come, inherit my kingdom. Come, take my salvation. I died on the cross in your behalf. I would love to forgive your sins and make you a child of my kingdom. And he makes his way easy and his gates open because he wanted. And his bosom is open. Can we be a savior as him? No, we can't. We cannot be savior. Right? We cannot be savior because we cannot die instead of people. The only Savior is our Lord Jesus Christ. What is also true, we can work with him to support and to help the salvation of others. And I'm telling you, this is the best way how to work the work of God. It's to help others to be saved. So that I wish for all of us to be very keen for the salvation of one another and for the salvation of the whole world. This is our job here. I must do the work. I must work the work of him who sent me, work his work. Support the salvation of people. Make the road to God easy to people and open. Give people encouragement. Give people hope. Tell people God can forgive your sins. Tell people God is happy to accept you. Make the way to their salvation open. Encourage. Support. Plant hope in people's heart and in people's life. Model for people. The model of the child of God. And they pray to God for the salvation of others. If you are doing that, you are working the work of God in the best way, because his main job is the Savior. And his second main job is he is the beneficial. Remember, every single liturgy, we pray and say, not only liturgy, every single prayer, let us give thanks to a, to who? To who? فلنشكر صانع إيه؟ الخيرات اسمه كده. This is his title. صانع الخيرات, the beneficial. صانع الخيرات means the beneficial. This is his title. This is his job. Because of that, in Acts chapter 10, 39-38, that the Holy Spirit concluded the life of our Jesus Christ in one statement. He said he was going around to do the good and heal people. Was his job. يقول يصنع خير ويشفي كل مرض وكل ضعف في الناس. This is the work of God. And that should be our work here. Listen, take it easy. Do simple work. When you get out of your house, remind yourself, how can I support the salvation of others in any simple way? How can I be beneficial to people in general? What kind of good I can do? Is it a cup of water? Acceptable. Is it holding the candle? Acceptable. Is it supporting people? Is it feeding a hungry? Is it clothing a naked? Is it welcoming a stranger? Is it welcoming a guest? Is it an inspirational talk to somebody sad, to comfort him? What kind of work I can do in every day of my life to work the work of God? And God is mainly a savior and is mainly a beneficial. I pray with all of you that God will open our heart before our ears to listen to his wisdom. And to understand that the purpose of our existence here, the purpose of our creation, is we are here because we are sent by God to earth to do the work of the one who sent us. And his main work is to save the human race and to be beneficial for the human race. I pray that God will remind our heart that we have to start from now, not after an hour or a minute, from now, to do the work of God, because it's a day. Before the night comes, because the night is coming. Glory be to God now and forever. Amen.